Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Lunar Eternal Blue Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We just came out of the Magic Trial Caves 2.0, that's what I call them. The same caves, well, not really, as from the first game. Just no wandering monsters at all. So we got two huge monsters to fight, and it was pretty fun. I enjoyed it. And we come out here, and this lady thinks that we're going into the caves. I read this last time. Says that. We already healed up here. And hello. Borgen's men left here a while ago. Lumina, you better hurry to the mansion. I'm worried about what Borgen may have done to your mother.
I know.
Huh. You'll sound like you're taking it seriously. So yeah, this is the city of Vane, in case you guys didn't know. What if I just left? So now I can truly get in here through conventional means. You can't wander on that side of the bridge. There's all kinds of people coming and going. They're mostly just walking back and forth. Hey, Lumina, who are these people with you?
These are members of my new magic guild.
Ruby says, really? This is news to me. Why do you keep trying to return Vane to its former glory? It'll never happen. You're bound to end up just like General Leo, scrubbing toilets for a living.
Silly. Lord Leo doesn't scrub toilets. What are you on?
I didn't say Lord Leo, stupid. I said General Leo. You know, the washed-up has-been entertainment refugee with the limited and very repetitive vocabulary. I think scrubbing toilets is the perfect job for that loser. Ruby says, no, I think licking the age-old muck from gutters would be more his speed. Okay, just one dialogue run for him. Hey there, kiddo. How's the money collection for Vane's future going?
Sorry, no time to talk. My mother's in big trouble. Sorry, gotta run.
Yeah, instead we're gonna look at every place around here, though. I don't know which one's the mansion. I want to see everybody first, though.
Hey, Lumina, how's the work on the Magic Guild going?
It's going pretty well. Got any more silver pop tops to donate?
Lumina, you're back. Show me one of your magic tricks, please.
Well, I have a special one I've been saving. It'll only cost...
Ruby says, don't tell me you're going to charge a kid to see one of your cheap tricks.
As I was about to say, it'll only cost you a big smile. How about it?
Wait. Lumina, why are you the only member of the Magic Guild?
Because qualifications are quite strict. In fact, it's so strict that no one else is qualified to get in. Maybe you will someday.
Good day, Lumina. Beth has been waiting patiently for your return. She wants to see a trick.
Well, she won't get to see it. She's been talking my ears off about how great your tricks are.
Well, it's nice to know I have a fan in the next generation.
History speaks of a time when Vane flowed with magic and floated in the skies. Nowadays, there's nothing left around here to remind us of that time. Except maybe the books in the library, but those things are falling apart.
Say there, you look like strangers.
Would you like to know about the systems of magic that the guild defined?
No, I don't have time.
Whoops, wrong answer. You're in Vane, home of the guild. I think you better listen.
Magic is classified into four basic systems that correspond to the elements. There's wind, fire, water, and earth magics. Recovery magic also exists. From these basic magic systems, all magic is derived.
Jean says, Hey, Lumina, this guy really seems to know a lot about magic.
Pooh,
It's all head knowledge. This guy doesn't even have magic power. He's just an egghead that likes to listen to himself talk. Isn't that right, Arvin? The books of the library here tell much more about Vane in our world. Lumina says, yes, yes. Well, that's quite obvious now, isn't it? What a meanie. I'm going to the library later to play ditch with my friends. Lumina says, hey there, the library is not a playground. Does your mother know about this? Some strangely dressed people went into the Guild Mansion a while ago. Talk about weird. Their leader was a Jenny Craig nightmare client. I'm from out of town, but I sure hope all the people here don't look like that. Now, if we step on there, we're gonna transport, right? No, huh? No. If you go south from here, you reach the port town of Azadal. Right, that's like Ronfort told us like 10 episodes ago that we were supposed to go there. There's supposed to be a lot of monsters around there. When I get big enough, I'm going to be a monster hunter. My friends say that Vane is going to be destroyed with this world. Is that true? No. Lumina says, Vane is going to be here for a long, long time. Ruby says, and even if it is destroyed, it'll happen so fast, you won't know she lied. Hey, Lumina, I'd rather get the magic of Blaze again, but I still can't get it right. Is there an easier magic I could start with? Nope, sorry, kiddo. If you can't get the magic of Blaze right, you're probably not cut out for magic. Why not try a paper route instead? I think I'll talk to these people. Yeah. Now, what is this? Is this the mansion? Because I really wanted to go there last, but let's check it out. Ah, welcome, travelers. Welcome to our city, a place rich in tradition and culture. Have you come to stay in our fair city? I can make you a deal on renting a room. This hotel has the best view of the city. If you stay here, I'll be your guide. You know, without a local guiding you, you'll miss all the best stuff. The only thing we have to show visitors in Vane is our historical sites. There's really not much else to do in this town. I feel sorry for the young ones. Lumina says, hey, miss, have a little faith. I'll revive the Magic Guild soon. When that happens, people will be coming from all over to see this place. Stuff looks so interesting, I wish I could interact with it, but nope. This big house, it's just the two of them walking around back and forth in that room. Let's try this one. Ah! We just moved here from Acido, but I already have a lot of friends. We're going over to the library to play later. Wanna come? Sorry, I can't talk right now. My friends are waiting for me at the library. We're gonna play Lance the Librarian. It's really fun. Lance the Librarian. I thought that was a wall. I brought my grandson here to escape the trouble they were having in Azadal. This town is filled with good people that really care about each other. I thought it would be a good place to bring him up. Lumina says, well, that's nice, but you should be paying rent. My mother is too nice. She lets people live here for free. Compared to the fear of monster attacks we faced every day in Azadal, this place is like a dream come true. Miria is a godsend. That's because you live here for free. Thinking these are walls or something. All these rooms, we can't do anything in them. Borgen appeared suddenly by using the magic of transfer. It really surprised me. All of a sudden, this huge mass appeared behind me. Lemia says, I can't believe he had the nerve to transfer right into the midst of our city. Hey, heard you were going away. Boy, Lemina, I'm really going to miss seeing you around here. I'm going to miss being seen, but it's only a temporary thing. I'll be back soon. Ruby says, sorry to rush your tearful reunion, but don't we have to save your mom, Lemina? Oh dear, yes, mother, we have to hurry. She forgot again. I've come from Arabia to see the sights here in historic Vane. I was told that this place is known for its spank shops. What is that? Would you be so kind as to direct me to one? I've been very bad lately. Lemina says, what are you, some kind of sicko? Spank shops? Where'd you hear that? I demand to know. Vane has never had places like that. Ooh, I just knew you were going to say that. I was warned that they were very exclusive and hard to find. But I'll keep looking. You can bet on that. Oops. Hi. Ho ho there, welcome to the Black Rose Quality Item Shop. Fresh ring. Oh, the lynx tail, range increases in combat. Is that worth it? Angel Tears resurrects the dead. Out of space. I'm gonna wait on this other stuff. This place you got back in. Hi. Oh. Can't heal at the statue? I mean, I don't need to, but whatever. Oh, that snake Borgen went over to the guild mansion and slithered inside. I don't trust that pile of putrescence. You better check it out. No kidding, Lemina says. We're on our way there right now. Thanks. First, we'll check out the items and armor. I mean, weapons and armor. We have a multitude of weapons for the magically challenged. Flame saber, which we have. Platinum scimitar. Okay, he goes forward, but is reaching behind. Mystic bow, thunder staff. Huh. I want to check this out. Hold on a second. Wait, it does say when we go into it. And why is he facing behind? He's facing backwards. His attack power goes up from 145 to 175. It's pretty damn good. Because he's full.
Oh, wait. Ruby. Now he's forward. I get it. It's because there's so much. They're so full. Okay, let's get rid of stuff here. Iron mace, okay. His attacks go down to only one, but his power goes up from 135 to 185. I'll do that. Thunderstaff is no good. Okay, let's sell the flame saber. And the battle hammer. Right? We got battle hammer. Iron mace is better. Right? Let's sell the flail too, finally. Sell the headband. Oh, definitely don't get rid of that. We can't even sell it. Mystic bow. There's a duplicate mystic bow. Get all those. Sell the iron shield. Guess we've been hanging on to that for a while. Restore status to normal. That's a holy water. Sunflower seeds heals the stone condition. So give one to Hero. And one to Ronfar. To Jean. Last one to Lamina. You got it. My protective items work equally well on magician and layman alike. Try one. Graceful dress, we got that. Battle dress. Nice. Okay, for Jean, her defense power goes up by 6, attack power goes up 5, and agility goes down, unfortunately. Oh well. I'm gonna equip that. Judgment Robe, we have that. Steel Shield, we have those. Iron Helm, we have that. Steel Bracelets. Pink Bow. Defense goes up. Sell this other headband. Sell the dress. Oh, there's that mask. What are we gonna do with that thing? Steel bracelet for all three of these guys. Round 4, defense up by 3. Jean, ditto. And Lamina, ditto. Did we replace other bracelets? Yeah, there's an iron bracelet. Now I guess, what's his name? Already has a... He can't wear a bracelet? Alright, continuing on. Snoop around their private quarters. Ever gonna find anything interesting behind these? Not this time, that's for sure. Oh. Let me through. Okay. Vane is not a bad city, it's just that nothing much happens here anymore. I'm thinking of moving to a big city like Moribia, where there's more going on. The Library. Magic Emperor Galleon. Galleon, one of the original four heroes, had very strong and unusual magic power. He used his power to take control of the goddess. Because of him, the land was plunged into an evil pit of darkness. If it were not for Dragon Master Alex, Galleon would have destroyed the world. We only hit these things once, because in the original game, you only had to look at them once, and they just repeated. Dragon Master History, Volume 1. The most popular Dragon Masters in history were Cyclone, Zeon, Iron Fist, Loka, Dain, and the last Dragon Master, Alex. Ruby says, I think I like Alex best. What about you, Hero? Yeah, I just want to see. The Blue Star, Legends and Lore. The blue star that shines in the sky above our world is our original home. Our ancestors guided to this land from the blue star by the goddess Althena. So I keep hitting it again. Anyway. Ancient Festivals, Volume 1. Festivals for the goddess Althena were not uncommon in the early days of Lunar. Most featured elaborate dances as well as singing in the goddess's honor. Jean says, that sounds like fun.
I want to revive that tradition. I can't look at this one. Understanding Magic, Volume 1. Magic requires great powers of concentration. To develop these skills, try this. Eat 2 boxes of laxatives and concentrate on not using the bathroom. Passing this test means not using the bathroom for 180 minutes. It's much harder than it sounds. And it sounds very hard. Basic Magic Volume 2. Things that go bop. That's it? History of Vane, Volume 1. Long ago, Vane was a great city. Only those blessed with magic could live here. The Magic Guild of Vane was the most powerful influence in the known world. The Final Dragon Master. The last true Dragon Master of this world was a boy called Alex. He married the human form of the goddess Althena, and they lived a long time. He married Luna? Neat. I really want to see if it says anything else. Nope. History of Vane, Volume 2. Vane once floated in the sky around Althena's tower. However, Luna blasted it down while under control of the Magic Emperor. So we're definitely being filled in on the events of the first game, guys. Hero, I never thought you were the type to go for a 5-finger discount. Get away from those. That's the special treasure of Vane. I'm the head librarian of the Vane Library. Our selection of literature is unmatched in all the world. Please take your time and read the books. You'll find it very enlightening. Go ahead, explore the Vane Library. We have books on virtually any subject. You know, books are the greatest asset we have. Through them, we can travel to the ancient past or the distant future. These times are so exciting, I can't believe we're actually living in it. But I wonder how the ending will be. It concerns me. Common Sense by Miria. A person's worth is determined not by their individual wealth, but by the sum total of their hopes, their dreams, and their actions. Okay, that's that one. It has been many centuries since Althena has come to us in human form. Does she trust that we have become self-sufficient? Or have we simply been abandoned? Ruby says, we know the answer to that now, don't we, Hero? We do. Basic Magic Volume 1. Piffs and Poofs. Jean says, who wouldn't be able to make a piff? This must be some kind of baby book. What color is love? What time is passion? Where is my heart? Show me these things, O goddess, beautiful and true. Lamina says, oh no, what is my poem doing out like that? Don't read anymore. But I want to. The Legend of Althena, Volume 2. Many years have passed since the goddess was born into this world as a human. It seems to be an indication that she believes our world is at peace. Understanding Magic, Volume 8, Love Potion Number 9. Ruby says, Hero, I think you may have read this book. Ah, Hero, don't be shy, you little devil. Anything different? No. 1001 Ways to Skin a Cat, Volume 1, Cafe Traditions. Ruby says, what is a book like that doing here? I think I'm going to be sick. You're not a flying cat, though. The Sealed City, Volume 1. There is a holy city across the sea where only special people can live. An evil has been sealed within its walls, never to be unleashed again. Understanding Magic, Volume 6. Training Pets with Shocks. Ronfar says, hey Chief, why not borrow this book? I bet... Oh, it's my disc defragmenter again, dammit. I bet you'd have Ruby ripped into shape in no time. I'll show you whipped into shape, you big idiot. The Blue Star, Volume 2. Some say that the strange lights seen in the sky are visitors from the Blue Star.
Lucia says, "What? You heard it. Or read it. I heard that ordinary people weren't allowed to come in here before. I'm very glad Miria changed that stupid elitist rule. Like Rush says, power to the people." Rush? Rush who? Lamina asks. You never heard of Giddy Lee? Oh, you mean the guy that looks like he should be Sally Struthers' chef? You couldn't pay me to listen to him. What? Now, no matter what a person's background, they can read these books. Well, all of them except Lamina's private collection. Making order out of this mess of books is tough, but it's my job, so I have to try to keep things straightened up. If you return the books to the place where you found them, it'd help me. Boy, I need all the help I can get. Don't worry, we're actually not taking any. I'm reading every book in this library so I can become a great scholar. That's what scholars do, you know? Read books and talk about what they've read. Sounds like just a job for me. Sorry, I don't have time to chat today. I have to keep studying. This library used to be for magicians only, but the previous premier of the Magic Guild, Miria, made it a public library. Now, anyone can use it. Frankly, I think it's much better. I wonder if there are people on the Blue Star, and if so, why don't they fall out of the sky into our world? I mean, they're just hanging there. Lucia, anything to say? All my friends will be here soon. I think we're playing Dewey Decimal Ditch today. I love playing in the library. It's so much fun. Lamina says, didn't your parents teach you that a library is not the place for fun and games? Well, since Lamina got on our case, we've decided to play in the Cave of Trial. On second thought, why don't you stay here and play? Your parents will kill me if I let you play in the Cave of Trial. We don't want any mauled kids on our hands, I guess. Inspirations, Volume 1. The future of each man lies in his own hand. Reach out and command your destiny. Basic Magic, Volume 3. Killing Barney Made Easy. Ruby says, hallelujah, it's about time someone wrote this book. Let's borrow it. Duh, huh, huh. I come here to get a book, I did. I want to have one with lots of pictures. I like pretty pictures. I'm trying to get smart enough to use that magic stuff, but Pa don't believe in me. Yeah, we're trying to look at this. Inspirations, Volume 2. See a penny, pick it up. All day long, you'll have good bowel regularity. 101 pickup lines, guaranteed to make the grade, Volume 1. Ruby says, hero, let's move on, okay? Well, he wants to use one on Lucia. I can't look at these books? What the hell? It's a travesty. Insomnia Solutions, Volume 4, Bats and Tire Irons. How to win at games of chance. Don't play. Ranfra says, what the hell kind of advice is that? I play all the time and always win. The Blue Star, Volume 1. There is a way to travel to the Blue Star, but no one has uncovered the method. So how do you know there's a way? It is rumored that it involves the Star Tower. Lunar and the Blue Star, past, present, and future. The history of the Blue Star is the history of war. People destroyed the only home they ever knew. Then the goddess Althina brought a select few to populate Lunar. Ruby says, hero, this is a very old book. It's in really bad shape. Can't look at these forward bookshelves. Chest. What are you doing? Get away from my treasure box this instant. That's off limits. Magic versus Karate, a comparison, Volume 1. Magic is a much more elegant solution than karate for all defensive situations. Lamina says, I don't quite agree with all this book says, but it does make some fine points.
101 Paths to Success, Volume 1, Devious Tricks. Amina says, I like some of the things in this book, although it does go too far sometimes. Magic Theory, Advanced Edition, an in-depth exploration of the mechanics and motion of spectacular magic. I think this volume is beyond your understanding. Let's try another. Big Business for Small Broads. This is my favorite book. The author is a former orphan. She became a successful businesswoman against all odds. It's so inspiring. Lamina's Books Rental Rates. All stores own all books owned by Lamina shall be only available by rental at the price of 100 silver. Oh, don't mind that price list. I'll let you guys read my books for free. Really, Lamina? You're being generous? Deceit in the Sky, the true history of the Vane Magic Guild scandal. This book is fascinating. It just details all the things that brought Vane down. Once I started reading it, I couldn't put it down. A Woman's Guide to Recycling, Volume 6, 101 Uses for Feminine Pads. This book is a complete waste of paper. I should recycle it. Inspirations, Volume 3. A Heart Full of Love Warms the Lives of Those It Touches. Okay. I can't see this book. All right. Okay, guys. Wow, we've not even done looking around Vane. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie. And don't stop that boogie.